Hello students, welcome to maths class. Today we will start a new topic, square roots by long division method. Objectives of this topic are square root of whole numbers, square root of decimal numbers. Today we will learn how to find square root of whole numbers by long division method. Students, in our previous classes we have already done a method to find a square root. That method is called as prime factorization method. Let's recall this method once. Here we need to find square root of 144, and under the prime factorization method, first step is to find the prime factors of that number, that is 144. So here I have find all the prime factors of 144 like this by Antenna method or LCM method. After that, second step is to write down all the prime factors under the symbol of square root as I have written here. Then next step is to make the pairs of the prime factors like this. Then next step is to take one number from each pair as 2 from the first pair, 2 from the second, and 3 from the third pair. Then after that we will multiply all the numbers, 2 multiplied by 2, 4, 4 multiplied by 3 comes out to be 12. That is the required square root of 144. So students, this is about the square root by prime factorization method, which we have already done in our previous classes. But if we are having large number, this method become little bit lengthy because we have to find so many factors for that. So in order to reduce that complication, we have a new method, that is square root by long division method, that we will discuss today. We have discussed long division method for the division of polynomials in algebra also. Today we will discuss how to find square root by long division method. So let's discuss all the steps which are used in finding the square root by long division method. Here we are going to discuss square root for the whole numbers, or we can say a number without decimals. So let's discuss all the steps with the help of an example. Here example is square root of 9801. For that our first step is do pairing from back or right. So first step is to do the pairing. We will do the pairing like this: from the back, 1, 0, first pair, 8, 9, that is our second pair. Whenever you need to find square root by long division method, always write down square table from 1 till 9 on the right hand side like this. I have written here 1 multiplied by 1 is equal to 1 till 9 multiplied by 9 is equal to 81. Then second step is find number from square table which is either equal to or just less than first pair. Here our first pair is 98. We are going to do the division with 98. So 98 is your dividend here. Then we have to see a number from the square table which is either equal to 98 or just less than 98. So on observing from the square table, we have got a number which is just less than 98, that is 81. Then after that we have to see that 81 is the square of which number. Here 81 is the square of 9. So write down 9 here, which will become your divisor, also here, which will become your quotient. So that 9 multiplied by 9 comes out to be 81, which we will write down under our first pair. Next step is to find the remainder. Here we will find remainder by subtracting 81 from 98, we have got 17, which is our remainder. Then fourth step is shift the next pair down and write it with remainder. It become dividend. Here our remainder is 17. We will shift the next pair, that is 01, down like this and write it with 17. So 1701 become dividend for our next step. Fifth step is double the quotient, it become new divisor. We can solve this step by two ways. First method, just multiplying the quotient by 2. Here 9 is our quotient, so multiply 9 by 2 and write down at the place of divisor. Another way which we will use in all the steps, that is just adding last digit of the quotient to the divisor. Here our divisor is 9. There is only one digit in the quotient, that is 9. So we will add 9 with the 9. That comes out to be 18. So write down 18 at the place of divisor, but write down 18 little bit farther than this line because we have to write down a digit here in the next step. Then sixth step is think about a digit which is to write with new divisor and quotient such that when divisor and that digit gets multiplied, we either got a number just less than or equal to new dividend. Let's understand how to solve this step. Here our divisor is 18 and quotient is 9. We have to think about a digit which is to be write with 18 and 9 such that when the divisor and the digit gets multiplied, we have either got a number which is equal to 1701 or just less than 1701. While thinking about a digit, must keep a last digit of the dividend in mind. Here our last digit is 1. So if I write here 1, 1 multiplied by 1 comes out to be 1, satisfied by the last digit. But if I multiply 181 by 1, because we have to write down 1 with the quotient as well and we have to multiply the whole divisor with the digit also. So 181 is so small than 1701, we have to think about another digit. If I write here 2, 2 multiplied by 2 comes out to be 4, not satisfied by this last digit. Then thinking in this way only, I have got a digit 9 which gets multiplied, gives you 81, which is satisfied by this last digit. So let's check that 189 multiplied by 9 will give you a number equal to 1701 or just less than 1701. So on checking, we have got a number equal to 1701. So we will write down 9 with the divisor as well as with the quotient. So that 189 and 9 multiplied by themselves will give you 1701, which we will write down under the divisor like this. Then our next step is to find remainder again, that we will got by subtracting 1701 from 1701. On subtracting we have got 0, and in the long division whenever we have got 0, we put the cross. After that, two cases can arise. Case 1, if remainder is 0 and no pair is left, then the new quotient is required square root. As in the above case, we have left with no pair and our remainder is also 0. So 99 is the required square root of 9801. So we will write down, therefore, square root of 9801 is equal to 99. Case 2 is, if remainder is not 0 and any pair is left, then repeat the steps from 4 to 7 till no pair is left. which we will discuss later on in another example.
So students, let's start with the first example, that is square root of 256. We know before starting with the calculation, we have to write down square table from 1 till 9 on the right hand side as written here. Then our first step is pairing. So start with the pairing. We know pairing should be done from the back like this. 6, 5, first pair, 2, one digit left, so leave it as it is. Then after that, our next step is find number from square table. We have to find the number from the square table which is either equal to the first pair or just less than the first pair. Here our first digit is 2. We have to find that number from the square table which is equal to 2 or just less than 2. So on observing from the square table, 1 is such number which is just less than 2. So 1 is the square of 1. So write down 1 at the place of divisor as well as at the place of quotient, such that 1 multiplied by 1 will give you 1. Write down 1 under the dividend. Then our next step is find the remainder. So we will find remainder by subtracting 1 from the 2. We have got 1. So write down at the place of remainder. Then our next step is shift the next pair down. After that, we have to shift the next pair, that is 5, 6 down, and write down at with the remainder. So 156 comes out to be our new dividend. So next step is double the quotient. For this step, you have to add last digit of the quotient to the divisor. Here our divisor is 1 and digit here is 1. So 1 plus 1 comes out to be 2.
The next step is to think about a digit which is to write with quotient and divisor. That means we have to think about a digit which is to be write with divisor 2 and quotient 1, such that when the digit and divisor gets multiplied, we have either got a number which is equal to 156 or just less than 156. While thinking about such digit, we have to keep last digit in mind. Here last digit is 6. That means we have to write down such digit here, such that when that digit gets multiplied by itself will give you last digit 6. Suppose if I write here 1, 1 multiplied by 1 will give you 1. Not satisfied by this last digit? If I write here 2, 2 multiplied by 2 is 4. Not satisfied by last digit? So thinking in such way, we have got a digit 4, such that 4 multiplied by 4 will give you 16. Last digit 6 satisfied. But before writing 6 here, let's check that 24 multiplied by 4 will give you which number. So multiplying 24 by 4 will give you 96, which is so small than 156. So think about the next digit. Here 6 is the next digit which is satisfied by the last digit. But before writing, let's check that 26 multiplied by 6 will give you 156, which is equal to the dividend. So write down 6 with divisor as well as with quotient, such that 26 multiplied by 6 give you 156. Then our next step is again to find the remainder. So subtract 156 from 156 will give you 0. And in long division, whenever we have got 0, we put cross. Here we are left with no pair and our remainder is also 0. So we stop our division here only. So 16 is the required answer. So write down, therefore, square root of 256 is equal to 16.
After that, we will continue with long division for 4-digit numbers.
Here our first example is square root of 7569. We will solve it step by step. as we have discussed all the steps, our first step is pairing, and we know pairing must be done from back or right like this. First pair is of 9, 6. So mark the pairs like this, 6, 9. Then second pair, 5, 7, like this. Also write down square table from 1 till 9 on the right side like this. Then our second step is find number from square table. So we will see a number from the square table which is either equal to or just less than our first pair. Our first pair is 75, so we have to see a number which is equal to 75 or just less than 75. Here we have no number which is equal to 75. We have got a number 64 which is just less than 75, and 64 is the square of 8. So we will write down 8 at the place of divisor as well as at the place of quotient like this, so that 8 multiplied by 8 comes out to be 64, and we will write down 64 under our first pair. After that, our third step is find the remainder. So we will find remainder by subtracting 64 from 75. So on subtracting, we have got 11 as a remainder. Then our next step, that is fourth step, is to shift the next pair down. So we will shift the next pair, that is 6, 9, down like this, and write down with the remainder, that is 11. So 1169 become our new dividend. Then our next step is double the quotient. We will solve this step by adding the last digit of the quotient to the divisor. Here our divisor is 8 and there is only one digit in the quotient. So we will add 8 to the 8, and 8 added to 8 comes out to be 16. But we have to write down 16 little bit farther than this line, because we have to write down a digit here in the next step. Then our next step is, that is sixth step, is think about a digit which is to write with quotient and divisor. So here we have to think about a digit which is to be write with divisor, that is 16, and quotient, that is 8, so that when divisor and that digit gets multiplied, we have either got a number which is equal to 1169 or just less than 1169. While thinking about a digit, we have to keep a last digit of the dividend in mind. Here 9 is the last digit, so we have to write down that digit here, such that when that digit gets multiplied by itself will give you a last digit 9. If I write here 1 multiplied by 1 is equal to 1, not satisfied by last digit 9. If write here 2 multiplied by 2, 4, again not satisfied. If I write here 3 multiplied by 3 is 9. That means we have to write down 3 at the place of divisor as well as with the quotient. But before writing, let's check that if I multiply 163 by 3, what we got? 163 multiplied by 3 comes out to be 489, which is so small than 1169, but we have to see a number which is either equal to 1169 or just less than it. So we have to think about some another digit. So thinking in this way only, I have got a digit 7, such that 7 multiplied by 7 comes out to be 49, satisfied by this last digit. But before writing with the divisor and quotient, let's check that 167 multiplied by 7 will give you which number. So let's check 167 multiplied by 7 comes out to be 9, 6, 11. So 167 multiplied by 7 gives you 1169, which is equal to this dividend. So 7 is satisfied here. So write down 7 with divisor as well as with quotient, so that 167 multiplied by 7 comes out to be 1169. So write down under the dividend like this. Then our next step is to find the remainder again, that we will got by subtracting 1169 from our dividend. So on subtracting we have got 0, and in long division whenever we got 0 we put cross. Here we are left with no pair and our remainder is also 0. So our current quotient, that is 87, become our required square root of 7569. So write down, therefore square root of 7569 comes out to be 87. That is our required answer.
So students, this is about how to find square root by long division method. Now I hope you have understood with this concept. Now you are able to do the related work which we have sent to you in a Snap homework. Thank you, students.